From popular messaging apps, games, and even the operating systems that run them, object-oriented programming's behind it all. But with all of that power can also come great confusion. If you're new to programming and struggling with where to start, you've come to the right place. Hi, I'm Steve, and I'm here to help you learn object-oriented programming fundamentals. In the following videos, we'll learn the fundamental components that make up object-oriented programming, providing some real-world and not-so-real-world examples along the way. There are a lot of different object-oriented programming languages out there, and it may feel like more get added every day, all with their own pros and cons. Some may be better suited for writing games, while others are better for writing programs that run on ATMs. But despite their differences, they all pretty much come down to the same core ideas, which is what we'll be learning about here. Having a strong grasp of these key concepts will help you to learn whichever language you choose that much faster. In the following videos, we'll introduce you to five major object-oriented programming topics: classes, objects, inheritance, encapsulation, and polymorphism. The way we'll be doing that is by creating our very own character for a massively multiplayer online role-playing game, or MMORPG for kind of short. Okay, with all that being said, I think it's important to state that this course does not go into specifics on any one programming language. In fact, there won't be any real programming at all, so if you don't know a method from a variable, don't worry. Instead, we'll be learning about the basic building blocks that are shared by pretty much every object-oriented programming language. That's important, so I'll say it again. These videos aren't about programming. They're about the concepts and ideas that are at the root of object-oriented programming. I mentioned that we'll be creating our own MMORPG character to help demonstrate the concepts that we're going to learn. Let's take a minute to discuss that a little more. For those who aren't familiar, an MMORPG is just a giant online video game where you get to create your own character and travel around on the map going on quests. What we're going to focus on is a bit about creating a character and showing how object-oriented programming makes that happen. Here we have our map and the four types of characters that we'll be working with. There's the wise and old wizard, cunning elf, rough and tumble orc, and the noble knight. We'll be getting a lot more familiar with these guys in future videos, but for now, I just wanted you to understand the whole MMORPG idea. You may be asking yourself, but Steve, why should I learn object-oriented programming? Well, for starters, the ability to code in an object-oriented programming language is currently one of the most highly sought-after skills in the workforce. And as all things digital continue to grow in importance in our everyday lives, that need is only going to increase. Or maybe you already have an idea for the next killer app that's going to take you to the top of the Silicon Valley heap, but you just need the tools to help build it. Either way, object-oriented programming can be a profitable skill to have. But above all, I think the best reason to learn object-oriented programming is because it's fun. No, seriously. Once you get the hang of it, writing your own object-oriented programs is a great way to flex your creative muscles and bring to life anything you can imagine. That is, once you get started. So let's get going.